Nifty opened on a flat to negative note, and for the first half of the trading session, the Nifty was trading in the negative. However, in the second half, the Nifty bounced back from 8730, 8740 odd levels, and thereafter closed the day on a positive note. However, it was flat by 2 points only. The market width was positive, with 930 advances to 531 declines. From the Nifty 50 pack, again, Reliance was the biggest contributor to the Nifty, along with Infosys, HUL, Dr. Reddy, IDFC, Tata Motors. On the losing side, we had HDFC Bank, HDFC Limited, Lupin, Cipla, L&T and TCS. Now we will have a look at the daily charts. On the daily charts, we can observe that the Nifty has closed in the positive for the 7th trading session, for the 6th trading session, in fact, and it has closed almost flat. The reason we are seeing such intraday volatility is that because the Nifty is trading at a crucial resistance area. 8800 on the upside is the 61.8% retracement level of this fall, which the Nifty has seen from the high of 9119 up to the low of 8269. So that is a crucial resistance area, and the Nifty is just trading above that. So the market is making up its mind whether the positive momentum continues or we see some retracement at current levels. At this point of time, there is no real sign of trend reversal, no trend reversal pattern is in formation. So our sense is that the positive momentum should continue on the upside in the coming trading sessions. Now moving on to the RB charts, you can observe that because of this sideways price action, there is some amount of negative divergence. However, the negative divergence will be confirmed only once we get a daily negative close. So until we don't get a daily negative close, we should continue, or we should, or the Nifty's positive momentum should continue on the upside. So we continue to maintain a positive stance. The Nifty is trading very close to our short-term target of 87.94. Once that level is reached on the upside, 88.55 on the upside, which is the daily upper Bollinger band, becomes the next crucial resistance. So until and unless that level is not reached on the upside, we continue to maintain our positive stance for a target of 87.94 on the upside. Now moving on to the chart of Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty failed to show the positive momentum from the last trading session. However, we saw some of the PSU banks like Oriental Bank of Commerce and some of the mid-sized PSU banks gaining in trade today. However, the heavyweights like ICICI Bank, HDFC Bank were on the losing side today. So that is reflected on the Bank Nifty chart. Overall, there is still some more upside left in the Bank Nifty, so we continue to maintain our positive stance on Bank Nifty as well. Crucial supports for Bank Nifty are placed at 18,580 and 18,350, 19,000 and 19,270 are crucial resistances. So overall friends, our view on the Nifty and Bank Nifty remain positive. Yes, we have been seeing couple of days of sideways consolidation for the Nifty. Negative divergence is also visible on the hourly charts. However, until and unless it gives a really bearish candlestick pattern or we get a trend reversal kind of a stuff, then until and unless that happens, we continue to maintain our positive stance. 8800 and 8855 on the upside are crucial resistances. 8739 and 8681 are crucial supports. That's all for today. Thank you.